from death into life. And Christians throughout the world are celebrating the awesome power of God. As we hear his word proclaimed today, as we reflect on all God has done, we share in that victory, Christ's victory over death. I have to tell you, I was here Friday night when Jan Fratello organized all these flowers, and she just did such a beautiful job. And this morning, I was the first one here, and as I came and I was looking around, and our windows are kind of dark in the morning, and I thought about Christ Church and how that beautiful window would light up for the sunrise service. That's a wonderful memory to hold on to. But we're going to sing, Morning Has Broken. So please, if you feel like standing, stand. If you feel like sitting, sit.
Christ the Lord is risen today.
we're going to be singing a verse or two of song afterwards. And if you want to remain seated for that, that's okay, and then Jan will stand again. Otherwise, you're going to be getting up and down a lot. So that's as you feel led, as the Spirit leads. Lord God, early in the morning when the world was young, you made life and all of its beauty. You gave birth to all that we know, sky and seas, plants and trees, bodies of light in the sky, creatures on the land, water and air, man and woman.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and it was so. God saw all that he had made, and it was very good. Thus the heavens and the earth were completed in all their vast array. By the seventh day, God had finished the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work. We're going to sing two verses for the beauty of the earth.
Thank you.
part of Good Fridays in my bulletin. And you may have part of Good Fridays in yours. So we're just going to kind of go with this. That's why you're confused, Harriet. There's a mistake in the bulletin. There's some of Good Fridays in there. So, but we're going to keep going, so bear with us. Early in the morning, a voice in a guarded graveyard. Now, wait a minute. Early in the morning, surrounded by respectable liars, religious leaders, anxious statesmen, and silent friends, you accepted the penalty for doing good, for being God. You shouldered and suffered the cross. And with these words, "It is finished," you put an end to your hopeless state of death, giving instead the promise of salvation and life.
Consider the heart of Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a human being, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. Would you join us in Jesus keep me near the cross?
had risen, and that you would come back to those and for those who had forgotten, denied, and destroyed you.
God raised Jesus from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him. God has raised this Jesus to life, and we are all witnesses of the fact. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
We're going to sing Alleluia, including the verses that are written, just little words at the bottom.
Thank you. met his disciples, women and men, young and old, and invited them into his new life. Jesus still meets his disciples, women and men, young and old, and invites us into his new life. That new life begins, as any life begins, with nourishment for the journey. At this table, we receive the bread of new life. At this table, we are called together for many individuals into one body. At this table, we are strengthened to answer Christ's call. This table doesn't belong to this church or to the United Methodist Church. The risen Christ is the host, and he bids us come and celebrate the feast to know the power of resurrection, the joy of heaven, the glory of God's grace.
Early in the morning, God created all that was good and beautiful. Very early in the morning, a mother placed her newborn in a manger. Very early in the morning, the good news was shared with frightened friends that Jesus was alive in our midst. Let us confess our fears and the amazement we bring this morning. Please join me. On this morning of our lives, we confess how human we are. We have done great good, but we have failed to do good. Through your Son, Christ with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forevermore. We are beloved children. We are forgiven children. Let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we
Would you join with us in the prayer after communion? Thank you, O Christ, for this feast of life. We are fed by your love. We are strengthened by your life. We are sent into this world to live your way and share your joy. We are now commissioned to feed as we have been fed, forgive as we have been forgiven, love as we have been loved. Thanks be to God.
We're still on my own. My voice is louder than Deb's. We're still not passing the plate, so if you haven't put your offering in, you're invited to do that. And if you want it to go to Homestead, we'll make sure it gets to Homestead. So. But if there's any loose offering in the collection plate today, we're going to use that for our Zimmerman experience. They're starting this coming week. And Thursday night at 7 o'clock, we're going to have a gathering, and I hope you come. It's just an informal gathering to get to meet them. And then the following Thursday, we'll start the book studies at 9:30 and at 6 o'clock. And that one, there'll be food at. But Thursday night, there may be some food that appear too, a little snack. But I hope you come and meet them. We didn't take prayer requests today at this service, but I have a couple little, a joy and a concern to lift before you. One is that Ruth Ann Hollis is home from her surgery and is doing as well as can be expected. And the other, that Vivian Young was in the hospital. We didn't even know that. So, but she's home and she's amazing. So I told her when she feels like having a visitor, let me know. She's really weak. But she said she would be watching on Facebook. So we love you, Vivian. And we have Karen, can you show that video? Mm-hmm. The Zimmermans did an Easter video for us that we're going to share now. And it'll be on Facebook later on.
Just give me one second. Get some volume.
Upon Christ's death, resurrection, and ascension, the apostles were left with a great work. Establish the church and spread the message of the grace of God to the world with help from the Holy Spirit. That same church exists today, and there is more to do.
Spending time with you in ministry in the Johnstown area. We're going to be preaching sermon series and doing some book studies and Bible studies and talking about mission outreach in the local area. So I hope that you are able to join us and that you clear your schedule to make it a priority to be a part of the opportunities and the events in which we have to share with you as a church. We're looking forward to getting to know your names and your faces and to be in partnership and ministry with you, a great mission and purpose that God has given for such a time as this. Well, as we come to the close of Easter, one of the things that we need to remember that Easter is not the end of the story, but Easter is really the beginning of the story. And thanks be to God for giving us the opportunity to be a part of that story for today.
Thank you.
Would you pray with me? Almighty God of resurrection power, you offer us life that overcomes death, light that overcomes darkness, hope that overcomes our deepest despair. What response could we offer? Our tithes and gifts, yes, but our minds, hearts, bodies, and witness as well. May our minds be about understanding who you are and who you long for us to be in this world. May our hearts overflow with your love and compassion for the poor, the oppressed, and the forgotten. May our bodies carry us out of the tombs of isolation to engage our neighbors as sisters and brothers. May our witness be the hallelujahs that we take with us to bring hope to everyone we meet. In the risen Christ we pray. Amen. Would you please stand as we sing He Lives? It's 310 in your hymnal, or Karen has the words on the screen.
Thank you.
excited. And then Thursday night, we had the most beautiful service at Homestead. It has to be up there, one of the top services that I have ever done. And it was just so beautiful. And Friday night, the service here was just so. I was done wallowing, and I started thinking about all the people who had touched me this past week, and Pastor Deb and Karen, you know, and Harriet are at the top of the list, but there were so many other people, and I just have to thank you, because I didn't think I was prepared the way I should be, but you made it that way, and I thank you. The night is far gone and the day is at hand, so let's cast off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. As Christ burst forth from the tomb, may new life burst forth from us, showing itself in acts of love and healing to a hurting world. And may the same Christ, who is the source of our new life, keep our hearts rejoicing and grant us peace this day and always. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen.